Wayakajillidock. Hello and welcome to the Rathbeeson Community Center Community Credit Union Arena for tonight's game between the Novas and the Bearcats. This is game number 10 of the 2023 Coltec Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League Championship Tournament. Let's send things downstairs for pregame introductions.
Between the Novas and the hometown Truro Bearcats, the hosting team, our Truro Bearcats, would like to take this time to acknowledge that Game 10 is brought to you by Vizio One. The officials of this evening's game, Elias Dunford and Cole Sellers, the referees, Travis Davis and Cyril O'Brien. We'd ask at this time, please stand and greet.
Pre-game introductions, we must take a moment to acknowledge that the Rathbeeson Community Center, the entire town of Truro, and the entire region covered by the Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League all lie within the ancestral, unceded territory of Mi'kma'ki. Taking a look at this game, it is the 0-2 Novas taking on the 2-0 Bearcats. Bearcats are the host team, but they got in here through the front door. They won their playoff series to get to this event, and they have shown that they belong here with victories over the Bedford Bandits and over the Gulls, the league's top team. Earlier today, a 6-4 victory against the Gulls. Taking a look at our starting goaltenders, Matt O'Hara makes his first appearance in this tournament for the Bearcats, and for the Novas, it is going to be Jack Bell getting his second start of the tournament. Bell played in yesterday's game and dropped that decision, so he's 0-1 with a 5.0 goals against average and 839 save percentage so far in the tournament. Novas lost yesterday 4-2 to the Storm. They lost earlier today 5-2 to the Storm. Lost earlier today 4-0 to the Wolverines. So they are 0-2 and in desperate need of a victory to try and make sure that they have a chance to get into tomorrow's semifinals. If they drop to 0-3, I think they would be mathematically eliminated at that point. I'll double check that, but so do not quote me on that, please. It'll depend on what the matchups are again for tomorrow's game. I'd have to take a closer look at that, but I think that 1-3 will not get you into the semifinals. So even if they win tomorrow, they might be out of luck. There's Watt with a shot as we are underway here at the Rathbeeson Community Center. Munden able to dump the puck down into the Nova zone. Back to get it there is Van Zupten. He'll play it up to Watt. Watt tries to make a pass. That's intercepted by Mullen. Mullen with a shot. That gets blocked. Now Watt back on the puck. He'll get it out to center. Munden able to get it over to Wolf. Wolf working in against McNeil. McNeil able to get to the puck first, though. He'll play it out. Knocked down there by McEachern. He'll get it ahead to Mullen. I should mention McEachern is Griffin McEachern of the Bearcats, one of three players with that surname in this game, as two members of the Novas are also named McEachern. We've got three McEacherns, two McDonalds, a McNeil, a McLean, a McClellan, and in O'Hara, who covers up the puck to get the first stoppage of the game with a minute 43 gone. As we run you through the standings at this point, the Truro Bearcats sit in second place right now. The New Scotland Storm lead the way with a record of 3-0. The Bearcats right now are 2-0. The Gulls sit with a record of 2-1 after their victory in the most recent game. That was a 4-0 win over the Jonald Jim Cougars. Here's Sheehan with the puck as he takes it back towards his own line, being watched by Kieran McDonald. Now gets the pass ahead to Hoyt. Hoyt will get it through to Doiron. Doiron has it knocked off his stick by McLean. The Jonald Jim Cougars sit at 1-2 after that loss. The Bedford Bandits are 0-3. Halifax Wolverines right now sit with a record of 1-1. They'll play their third game coming up in the next game. That'll be against the Bedford Bandits. And Truro right now 2-0. So let's run you through the standings. The New Scotland Storm with a record of 3-0. They have victories over the Novas by a score of 5-2. They beat the Jonald Jim Cougars 5-1 and beat the Bedford Bandits 5-2. So 15 goals scored, 5 goals given up for the Storm to get them to that 3-0 record. Truro Bearcats sit in second with a record of 2-0 with wins over the Bandits and the Gulls. Gulls are 2-1. That puts them in third with victories over the Bedford Bandits and the Jonald Jim Cougars. Their loss coming to the Truro Bearcats, as mentioned. The Halifax Wolverines right now sit in fourth with a record of 1-1. With a win earlier today over the Novas, a loss yesterday against the Jonald Jim Cougars. The Cougars sit in fifth right now with a record of 1-2. After they beat the Halifax Wolverines yesterday, a pair of losses today against the New Scotland Storm and the Gulls has them at 1-2. Sixth place right now are these Novas with their record of 0-2 after the loss yesterday against New Scotland Storm and the loss earlier today against the Wolverines. And in seventh place, the Bedford Bandits with a record of 0-3 to this point after they've dropped games against the Gulls, the Truro Bearcats, and the New Scotland Storm. So that runs you through the standings. And with a team at 3-0, two teams with two victories, and the Cougars at 1-2, and the Wolverines at 1-1. It is still technically possible to get into the semifinals with a record of 1-3, but you would need a lot of things to go your way, including a tiebreaker formula that works for you. So for the Novas, this really is a must-win game if they want to try and control their own destiny to get into the semifinals. For the Bearcats, with their record of 2-0, they still have their sights on the number one seed going into the semifinals. There's a shot save made by O'Hara. Puck comes back to Van Zupten at the point. There's a shot save, and the puck was there for Carson McEachern, but he couldn't quite get his stick on it to get the second chance opportunity against Matt O'Hara. With 4:41 gone here in the first period, and the Bearcats and Novas both still looking for the first goal of the game. Draw one back to the line. Trenum with the shot. That goes wide. Comes off the end board. Both number 12s go after it. Sheehan and Kieran McDonald. Now with it is Munden. He'll dump it down into the Nova zone. Trenum goes back after it into deep in his own end. Gets the puck ahead to Carson McEachern. McEachern working his way in against Hunt. Takes the puck to the outside all the way behind the net. Now he'll come out the near side. Tried to get a pass over to Fleet, but that was broken up by White, who got it up to Munden. Munden gets as far as the Nova's line before he turns the puck over. Now Carson McEachern back on it again. His pass for Fleet. He just pokes it towards the net, and O'Hara will cover up and hang on for a faceoff. 5:25 gone here in period number one. Again, this is the 10th of 14 games through the preliminary stage of the tournament. Seven teams, each team plays four times, so it's an incomplete round robin. Top four teams, as we mentioned, make it into the semifinals. Those will be played tomorrow evening. And then the bronze and gold medal games will go on Sunday. Puck comes up the wall. Anderson trying to work it back down the boards. That gets cleared away. Now here's Fraser working his way ahead. Fraser tried to get a pass to Vora. It doesn't get all the way through to him as it was knocked down there by Thomas McEachern. Now every McEachern in the game has touched the puck at least once. Anderson will get it ahead for McEachern. Sorry, that's Broussard. As I've mentioned a couple times already, it's hard to tell sometimes with the Nova players with no numbers on the sleeves unless you can clearly see their back as to who's who. Here's Watt with the puck. Watt gets a shot away, kick save made by O'Hara, and McNeil will fire it around the boards. And it's played out past Van Zupfen. Down the ice, McNeil back to get it, nearly runs into his defense partner, plays it ahead, that gets beyond Watt, and into the Truro zone, backing up with it is Griffin McEachern. He'll play it ahead for Mullen. Mullen gets the pass over to Sullivan, he'll carry it forward. Sullivan fires a shot, that goes wide, Mullen gets to the puck, throws it towards the front of the net, it gets beyond Wolf. Now played back to the line, Sullivan, his shot is blocked. Mullen couldn't pull the trigger as he had open net to work with. Now the puck goes off the glove of Bell. Back to the line, Sullivan. His shot goes through the feet of Wolf and into the far corner. Hookshorst will get to it and play it ahead for Watt, who comes out to center. Watt will just dump the puck down into the Truro zone, and the Novas will make wholesale changes. While back to get the puck is Sullivan for the Bearcats. Sullivan with the long lead pass. That gets beyond Wolf. It goes right onto the net, and Bell will cover up as Cream is coming in. And we'll get a stoppage just over the midway point of period number one. I've made this comment about the red outfit, the red jerseys and socks, and the whole ensemble for the Truro Bearcats. The white one looks just as good. And I got to say, it's very reminiscent of, you know, Colgate or Boston College, or not Boston College, Boston University, that very NCAA kind of feel to this uniform for the Bearcats, especially with the, when you include the stripe down the helmet, really, really sharp. Really sharp. Carson McEachern has that puck knocked off his stick. McLean gets it. That was McLean. I was right the first time. As someone who does not have the same Scottish ancestry as many people in this province, I will confess I do end up getting a little bit confused when I've got this many Macs in the two lineups combined. You've got a McDonald, a McEachern on one side. That's easy enough. But then you've got a McNeil, a McEachern, a McDonald, a McEachern, a McDonald, a McLean, and a McClellan as you go down the Nova roster. Back to get the puck is Hunt. He gains the red line, dumps the puck right in onto Bell, who steers that aside. Now Fleet will get it. He'll play it ahead for Broussard. Broussard working his way in, has the puck stolen from him by Vora. Backhand shot, save made by O'Hara. Because, you know, you need one good Irish name in amongst all the Scots. Broussard brings it around the boards. Puck gets the line for Patrickin. He couldn't quite hold it onside. Of course, Petter being a good British name there as well. I can't comment too much. .540 left to go here in the first period. And I mean, I want to be clear, I mean no offense here. I'm poking fun at my own inability to keep names straight. I'm not poking fun at the team and the players. I want that to be perfectly clear. It is meant to be self-deprecating humor. If it came across any other way, I do apologize. I know sometimes my self-deprecating humor sometimes ends up appearing a little bit the other way. And we're going to get some penalties here as there was a battle down below the goal line, and it looks like it's going to be a penalty each way as Van Zupfen will go to the box for the Novas, and his counterpart wearing the same number 16 goes in for the Bearcats, Doiron. Coincidental penalties coming with 5:16 left to go, or 5:17 left to go. It's number 16 on each team who got the penalty. Wolf with the puck as we continue to play 5-on-5 with the coincidental penalties. Now Murphy, he plays it off the boards down towards the corner. Mullen gets it in front for Wolf. There's a shot, a nice save made by Bell. Van Zupfen gets roughing. Doiron also gets roughing, so not only are they coincidental penalties, but they are coincidental roughing penalties with 9:43 gone in the period. Now here comes Carson McEachern. His shot is blocked. That was 24, McLean. And I could see the 4, and I could see the N at the end of the name. So I thought I was looking at a 14 McEachern, not a 24 McLean. 4:29 left to go in the first period. Carson McEachern in to take the draw against Hoyt. McEachern wins it back. Played across to Anderson from D to D. Right, shot ahead and Sullivan there to get that one. Now they battle right in front of the Nova's bench. Hoyt will get it down into the Nova zone. Thomas McEachern there. He takes a bump. Gets it to Carson McEachern. And he will get it ahead for Kieran McDonald, who feeds it to Boyd. Boyd tries to get it back through, but that's turned over to the Bearcats. That pass misses the intended target and will go the length of the ice, and so we'll get an icing with 3:55 gone here, or left to go rather, here in period number one. Face-off will be to the right of Matt O'Hara. Nova's win the draw, back to the line for McNeil. Sent behind the net. Griffin McEachern gets to it for the Bearcats. He plays it ahead to Sullivan. His pass forward from Munden. Munden couldn't take it cleanly, and McClellan will bring it the other way. McClellan with a shot. That goes wide. Comes up the wall. Trenum gets to it at the line. His shot ends up being deflected by Griffin McEachern, and it nearly ends up fooling O'Hara. McEachern able to eventually clear it away. Now the pass intended for Munden. That gets beyond him, and it'll go the length of the ice for an icing call with 3:26. left in the first period, and the faceoff will come back down into the Truro zone once again. Bearcats and Novas tied, still looking for the first goal of the game. As Watt lines up to take the draw against Mullen, both number 19s in there. Hunter McDonald had the puck for a second. Now Watt kicks it up from him. He'll play it back to the line. Anderson with it. His shot deflected, and it ends up on top of the net. And nearly a pretty quick stick there by Hookshorst as he tried to knock the puck off of the net and then in, but the referee blew it down before that could take place. We'll get the two number 19s to take the draw again. This time it's back to Anderson. He plays it across to Thomas McEachern, who will send it around the boards behind the net. McLean trying to, or that's not McLean, excuse me, that is Hookshorst trying to get it back out in front. Hookshorst behind the net. Gets to the puck in the far corner, takes a bump there from Hunt. Was able to leave it for his teammate, who plays it back to the line. Thomas McEachern across to Anderson. He'll send it down low. Hookshorst now behind the net, tries to get it out in front for Hunter McDonald. He couldn't get his stick on it, and it's kicked over the wall where Murphy will get it. He'll play it back to Sheehan. Sheehan across for Hunt, who gets it ahead to Murphy. Murphy ends up kicking it in towards the Nova net. Bell settles it there for Anderson. Now it's up high into the air, comes down in neutral ice. Hookshorst not able to get it away from Mullen, who plays it back down into the Nova zone. Anderson trying to get away from Wolf. Will now play the puck over to Thomas McEachern. He gets it ahead for Watt, who will dump it the rest of the way down the ice. It goes all the way around the far side wall. Mullen will pick up there. Take it down below his own goal line, in behind the net, out the near side. Has that pass picked off by Kieran McDonald. Carson McEachern couldn't get his stick on it. Now Doiron will play it ahead. Boyd with the steal there. He gets it over to McLean. McLean will bring it right back into the zone. Sends it off the end boards. Paris plays it up the near wall. And now coming out with it is Hoyt. Hoyt gets the puck into the Nova zone. But they pick up there and come the other way. The pass for Boyd doesn't connect, and White will send it back deep into the Nova end with 84 seconds left to go in the first period. White takes a bump from a couple of players, 14 and 24, so that's Carson McEachern and Angus Huey McLean. Pass ahead intended for McEachern, gets deflected away, and then O'Hara didn't quite pull the puck in close enough to himself there, and made that play a little bit more difficult for himself than he perhaps had to, but was able to smother the puck and hang on for a faceoff with 106 left to go in the first period. Played back to the line. McNeil down into the towards the corner. Vora able to play it around to the far side. Sullivan gets it as far as the line, bends up, then holds it in there. And the shot, O'Hara gloves that down, gives it to Sullivan. He plays it forward for Frazier. Frazier will get the puck out to center ice, plays it off the wall, tried to get it to Green, but it ends up coming back to Frazier, knocked off his stick. Now Sullivan steps up. He can't go anywhere with that. But it's dumped in. With 25 seconds left, Griffin McEachern, long lead pass, but McNeil able to break that one up. He gets it ahead, and it goes into the feet of McDonald, that being Hunter McDonald. Now McDonald trying to work his way forward, plays it off of the side of the net. Hunt will gather that in. And Hunt coming up with 5 seconds left, goes to dump the puck down into the Nova zone. It's knocked down right at the blue line, and as the puck comes back to Sheehan, he will hang on and run the clock out. Shot 6-6 in the first period. Both goalies make 6 saves, which means we've played 15 minutes and we're still looking for the first goal of the game. While we have a moment here, let's take a moment to acknowledge the Game 10 sponsor of the Coltec Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey Championships is Physio One Health Clinic. As well, the major sponsors throughout the tournament: gold level sponsor Coltec Windows and Entrance Systems, silver sponsor Andy's Tire Shop Limited, SBM Offshore, and Maritime Trust Limited. And the bronze level sponsors include Motor Hub Automotive Group, Stanfield Limited, Dairy Queen, and Virtual McDougall. And as we've mentioned many times throughout the day, it's worth mentioning again though, events like this cannot happen without that corporate sponsorship to help make sure that the players are able to live their dreams here on the ice. And we appreciate so much all of the work that all of the corporate sponsors have done, as well as all the work that the volunteers are doing here at this event as well. Such a great group of volunteers here at this tournament, and they deserve a big shout out as well. As we get the second period underway, Broussard ends up with the puck for the Novas. He gets it down deep into the Bearcat zone. Left behind the net there by O'Hara. It's played around the wall to the near side. Wolf, he'll get it out to center. Broussard sends it back down into the Turo zone. Sheehan now, he'll play it ahead. Munden knocks that puck down with a high stick. But it was next touch by Anderson before Munden got it back again. Munden trying to work his way in against Anderson. Anderson outsized there, but not outmatched. Good effort there by the defenseman to keep Munden to the outside, but now the puck is picked up in the corner, and coming out with it is Mullen. He turns and fires. That shot goes wide. Munden gets to it in the corner, plays it up the wall. It comes all the way back to the line. Sheehan with a shot. That gets blocked, and the Novas will come back out with it. It is Anderson working his way ahead in across the blue line. Anderson still with the puck, ends up just losing the handle on it. Now gets it back, takes it behind the net, and we're going to get a penalty against the Novas. It's going to be an interference call as McClellan ran a bit of a pick for Mullen there, or for Anderson there. So we'll get the first power play of the game 58 seconds into the second period. And we can tell you that the Novas, who are going shorthanded, have been good on the penalty kill so far this tournament, and they've needed to be as they have been shorthanded 12 times through the first two games, and they have gone 11 out of 12 on the penalty kill, giving up just the one power play goal. The Bearcats have hardly had power play opportunity. They are 0 for 2 through two games in the tournament. They went 0 for 1 in their opening game. They went 0 for 1 in their second game. Just two power play opportunities in the first two games, as the puck ends up hitting a player on one of the benches as it was cleared out of the Nova zone. 22 seconds gone in the penalty. A minute 20 gone here in period number two, as we still look for the first goal of this game. Hookshorst will take the draw against Vora. Puck is one towards the wall by Hookshorst. It's cleared to the line and out just past Sullivan. He plays it over to Griffin McEachern. His pass ends up deflecting up into the Truro bench, and we'll get another stoppage with 30 seconds gone in the penalty. As Vora and Hookshorst will take the draw again. Hookshorst wins it to McNeil this time. He'll play it as far as the Truro line, picked up there by McEachern. McEachern gets the pass ahead to Vora at the far wall. Vora stops. Now plays it to the near side for Mullen. Back over to Vora. He deflects it down into the corner, chases it down, plays it towards the front of the net, but it hops past everybody except for, was that McDonald? Yes, it was, but which McDonald? Hunter McDonald. Couldn't quite see the full number, so I couldn't tell for sure if that was a 15 or a 12. Now in the near side corner, McEachern, Thomas McEachern takes a bump there. Puck comes to the front of the net, batted away by Bell. Now Vora gets it. His shot goes wide. Puck comes up the wall. McEachern holds it in at the line. Down for Hoyt. He's met by Thomas McEachern. Frazier comes over to help try and work the puck free. Frazier does get it free. He takes a bump then from Carson McEachern. As all three McEacherns on the ice at the same time, McEachern's shot gets through the attempted block by McEachern. Now Hoyt with a shot. That gets blocked, and Broussard will clear it away, and Carson McEachern will pick up, coming in one-on-one against Griffin McEachern. Coming up is Broussard following up. He gets a shot away, and the save made by O'Hara. Griffin McEachern will clear it away from the front of the net. Carson McEachern in still, forechecking. Now McEachern delivers a hit on McEachern while the puck is played around to Mullen. Mullen in across the line. Sends the puck towards the net. It goes off the side of the net, and McNeil will get it. We're back to 5-on-5. Pass ahead for McClellan, who has just come out of the box. McClellan working his way ahead. His pass a little bit too far in front of Carson McEachern. And now it's sent up the other way. It'll roll all the way through onto Bell, and he'll cover up as Munden was making his way in. And we'll get a stoppage with 11:39 left to go here in the second period. Faceoff will be in the Nova zone, to the left of netminder Jack Bell. Hoyt to take this faceoff for the Truro Bearcats against Hunter McDonald. After a battle for the puck, Watt gets it out to center. It's knocked off his stick by Sheehan, and Thomas McEachern brings it in. He'll play it off the end boards. In behind the net, Hookshorst tries the wraparound, but the puck ends up going through the crease all the way to the near wall. Now Hoyt. It's played out to center. Thomas McEachern will dump it back in again. Sheehan picks up below his own goal line, plays it ahead for Doiron. Doiron sets it up for Hoyt, but they don't quite connect. Now Doiron able to get it up to Hoyt. Hoyt didn't see a good passing lane to get it across to White, so just sends the puck deep into the zone. Goes after it against Anderson against the end boards. The Novas get the puck to the line and out as Watt plays it off the wall, but then Frazier sends it back in. Carson McEachern will go back and pick up and play it ahead. That misses everybody and goes down the length of the ice. With 10:38 to go in the second period, we'll get an icing call against the Novas. And the faceoff will come back deep into their zone. Vora in to take the draw for the Truro Bearcats. Carson McEachern, the captain, taking the faceoff for the Novas, but he'll get waved out of the faceoff circle. Kieran McDonald will come in to take the draw instead. Vora wins it to Frazier, who plays it back to the line for Paris. He plays it towards the near corner, but the Novas are able to get it, send it out to center. Now Boyd works past Patrickin. Boyd with the puck. He's got a shot, and O'Hara makes the save. He had Carson McEachern as an option for a pass. McEachern now gets tripped up, and that's going to be a penalty against Truro. And we'll get the penalty for tripping against Ryland Patrickin with 10:14 to go in the second period. And the Novas will get their first power play of the game. We can tell you the Novas are 0-for-8 so far with the man advantage. The Bearcats, 7 out of 8 penalty kills so far, which is 87.5% efficiency. McEachern wins the draw back to McNeil. He'll play it across to Anderson. Back to McNeil again. His shot goes off of Vora into the far corner. McEachern battling there with Boyd. Now it comes around to the near side. Carson McEachern will get it to McNeil. McNeil battling with Cream. Gets the puck down towards the corner. Boyd and Griffin McEachern collide there. McEachern trying to tie up the puck for the Bearcats. Now it comes free. Kieran McDonald will play it back to the line for McNeil. There's a shot. That goes just up over the crossbar. And the puck will come to the line. Anderson does hold it onside. Now Boyd with the puck. He drops it to Carson McEachern. Back to McNeil. Across to Anderson. There's a shot. He scores! Duncan Anderson on the power play gives the Novas the lead. And for Anderson, that is, as I try to find him here, there he is, his first goal, first point of the tournament. And it is a big one to give them the 1-0 lead over the 2-0 Truro Bearcats. As we get confirmation of the goal, Boyd and Kieran McDonald with the assist. So once again, Duncan Anderson, his first goal, first point of the tournament, assisted by A.J. Boyd and Kieran McDonald on the power play, 5 minutes and 34 seconds into the second period to give the Novas the 1-0 lead. There we go, as it takes a second or two for your scoreboard to catch up to the buttons that I press. 8:50 left to go here, second period. 1-0 for the Novas. Hunter McDonald and his counterpart wearing the same number as him. Or no, that was Mullen, not 15. I should know that, because 15 for the Bearcats is a defenseman, Troy Hunt. Now here's Trenum with the puck. He'll play it off the end boards over to McNeil near side. He'll get it up to Hookshorst. Hookshorst ahead for Hunter McDonald. He'll bring it in across the line, try to feed it to Watt. That pass goes a little bit behind him. And now Hunt will get it ahead. That pass goes beyond Doiron down the ice. And Trenum back to pick up below his own goal line. He'll play it to McClellan. McClellan fans on his pass attempt. White got his stick on it, but he ended up putting it right onto the stick of Trenum. He was able to get it ahead, and the Novas out to center. That pass for Hunter McDonald. He was trying to head off for a change. Just dumps the puck down and then makes that change. Now Fleet behind the net. He takes a bump, and Mullen gets it, and will send it down the length of the ice. It'll end up coming right onto the net and hitting Jack Bell, so no icing. And Thomas McEachern came back, got to the puck, played it ahead. And it's turned over to the Bearcats there. Munden can't get it to sit for him. Now Thomas McEachern back on it. He'll play it ahead to McClellan, who gets it across the line, but it's sent right back out again. Picked up by Anderson. Here comes Anderson working his way in. His shot is blocked. Second chance blocked. And the third opportunity ends up going just wide of the net after O'Hara made the save on the second shot. The first shot was blocked before getting all the way there. Now Fraser trying to get the puck out to center. He does. 7:10 left to go, second period. Hoyt on the puck. He's got McClellan all over him. Van Zupten in there as well. Now they battle right at the blue line. The puck comes to Griffin McEachern. He'll work his way ahead for the Bearcats. Trying to get beyond Broussard. Broussard takes him into the wall. Munden picks up the puck that came loose. Now Sullivan will get it ahead. And it's deflected down into the Nova zone. Anderson plays it over. Out across the line. Back in across the line. Van Zupten now sends it across to the far side for Kieran McDonald. And he'll fire it down the ice. Back to get it is Sullivan. Sullivan plays it around the wall. McEachern will hold it in. That being Carson McEachern. Bora now gets it out to center. Van Zupten goes to dump it back in again. It's knocked off of Murphy. Frazier then gets it ahead. It's turned over at the blue line. Back over to the center ice line. Now McEachern, Carson McEachern working in. Gets a shot away. The glove save made by O'Hara. And he will hang on for a faceoff with 6:08 left to go here in the second period. Novas with the 1-0 lead. Novas have had some struggles offensively in this tournament so far, scoring just 2 goals in their first 2 games. So important for them to get a lead and have some time playing with the lead here. Here's Doyron with the puck down. He'll get it up to Wolf. Wolf has Mullen coming up with him. Trenum able to knock the puck off of Wolf's stick. Now it comes back to the line. Shot from Sullivan. Didn't have much on that. Losing his footing there was Trenum. Doyron doesn't get much on his shot. Mullen gets his stick in there, but Bell able to find the puck and cover it up for a faceoff with 5:44 remaining here in period number 2. The Truro Bearcats trailing the Novas here by a score of 1-0. Both of these teams have 1 more game tomorrow. Bearcats will be in the final game of the round robin against the Charlottetown Cougars. Novas will play the first game of the day tomorrow at 8 a.m. against the Gulls. As Cookshorst gets it ahead, Watt couldn't take that pass as it was knocked away. Now Doyron coming the other way, but that's going to be an offside against Truro. And so we'll get a stoppage with 5:21 left here in the second period. Faceoff will be on the left wing side as the Novas look at it. The right wing side as you're looking at it from a Truro perspective. Cream gets the puck in across the line. Anderson plays it over to Thomas McEachern. He'll get it ahead. And McClellan will bat it the rest of the way down the ice. But he was on his own side of center when he did. So we'll get an icing call with 5:11 left to go. Faceoff will come back down into the Nova zone. It'll be to the left of the netminder, Jack Bell. Mullen in to take the draw against Broussard. Bearcats get it off of the draw. Sent down into the corner by Sheehan. A setup pass from Mullen for Cream. And Cream fires the one-timer wide. The puck goes all the way out and down the ice. Now Hunt with it in his own zone. He'll get it ahead. Hoyt with the shot. That goes wide. Puck comes back to the line for Hunt. He'll fire a shot. Save. Puck is loose and cleared away from the front of the net by Thomas McEachern. Sheehan can't get it dumped back in as McClellan knocks that down. McClellan coming in. He's got Fleet with him. McClellan with a shot. Save and the rebound will be cleared away by White. White skates it ahead. In across the Nova blue line. Down into the corner. Back to the line for Sheehan. He tries to work it back down low, but Carson McEachern intercepts that. Gets it back out to center. Sheehan will play it to the near side now for Hunt. He'll dump it in. Comes off the end boards. And Trenum will pick it up and play it forward. Attempted clear, gets knocked down. Now Vora gets to the puck at the far wall, gets it in front for Munden. Munden has it knocked off a stick by McNeil. And then the puck ends up bouncing to Vora, who sends it on target, but Jack Bell able to make the save and hang on. Just under 4 minutes left to go here in the second period. It's the sixth game of the day. I'm losing track of what period I'm in here. I'm losing track of what game it is. I'm losing track of just about everything at this point. Paris from the line. He fires a shot. Frazier now from a sharp angle puts that one off at the side of the net. And coming out with it is Kieran McDonald. Throws it towards the slot. Patrickin was there to get it for the Bearcats. He plays it as far as the line. McLean fires a blast, but that goes wide. Now at the line, that shot from Dan Zupton, I think it was. Couldn't quite see the whole number. Now I can see, yes, it was indeed Van Zupton. There's a big shot delivered there by Frazier. Puck is sent down the ice and ends up going right onto O'Hara, so he has to settle it for Paris. 3:11 and counting left to go here, second period. Paris gets the puck ahead to Frazier. In across the blue line. Frazier with a shot. That goes wide of the net. It'll come all the way up the boards and out to center. Murphy chases it down, plays it back to Sullivan. Sullivan gets it ahead for Frazier. He'll bring it back in across the line again. Frazier cutting towards the net, gets the shot away, save, rebound, and a second save there by Bell. But now Mullen steals it, and another save by Bell, but the fourth chance goes in. Bell made three saves before Malky Murphy was finally able to get one past him. I don't know how many goaltenders you can ask to make a fourth straight save on a sequence like that and expect them to get it. What a sequence there. Jack Bell did everything he could, but the Truro Bearcats just kept pressuring and pressuring and pressuring, and finally Malky Murphy able to take advantage and get the first goal and first point of the tournament. So Frazier, actually they give the goal to Frazier. I thought it was Murphy who scored that. It sounded like they said Frazier from Murphy and McEachern. And now we'll have a stoppage as Bell's net has come loose. 2:03 left to go in the first period. If it was indeed Frazier's goal, I thought for sure it was Murphy. But if it was Frazier's goal, that's his second goal, second point of the tournament. And that ties up the game at one. Mullen now throws it through the crease. It goes to the far side. Murphy couldn't get his stick on it. The Nova's able to come out, but that pass ends up hitting Broussard in the skate. Now Fleet brings it in. He'll send it down below the goal line. Sullivan there. He'll get it ahead. And Wolf will come out with it. His pass a little bit behind Mullen. Mullen able to pick it up off the far wall. Has it poked off his stick by Trenum. And now coming the other way, here's Fleet. He's got McClellan coming up with him. Fleet brings it in across the blue line. Fires a shot. That goes high. Comes around to the near side wall. McClellan takes a hit from White. Puck heads towards the net. Now it comes back to the line. McNeil, his shot. That hit Hoyt. And now Broussard in the far corner. Takes it behind the net. Tries to get it out in front, but White will intercept that. Get it over to Murphy. Murphy gives back to White. And White will come in across the blue line. Fire a shot. Bell to save. Rebound. McNeil couldn't clear it away as Hoyt got on the puck. And now it's cleared out to center. Sheehan dumps it back in again. Doiron tried to come back into the zone a little bit too soon. Now the Novas look to work their way out. McClellan, he gets tied up by Hoyt along the near side wall inside the Nova zone. Puck comes free to Hoyt, to White. He sends it towards the net. Trenum able to pick it up there, though. He'll clear it away. Now start to carry it ahead with 34 seconds left in the period. Pass forward for Kieran McDonald. He'll send it down deep into the Truro zone. Back to get it is Hunt. His pass ahead beyond the reach of Frazier. Van Zupten will hustle back and get on the puck. Gets it ahead to Kieran McDonald. He gets it as far as the line. Sheehan will play it back down low. Doyren now has Mullen heading towards the net. Takes the shot. The save made by Bell. And that'll be cleared out to center. Hunt with 7 seconds left in the period. Now Hunt back on it again. And we'll get a stoppage with 0.4 seconds due to a hand pass. And a neutral zone faceoff with 0.4 seconds. Somehow I don't think we're going to see much more action in this period. As, yeah, they drop the puck and that's it. So no scoring in the first, a pair of goals in the second. The Bearcats with 11 shots on goal in that second period. The Novas with 8, so the two-period total is 17-14 in favor of Truro. And so at the end of two periods, it is Bearcats 1, Novas 1. We're going to take a break, come back, get you ready for the third period. In just a few minutes, you are watching the Coltec Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League Championship Tournament here on Atlantic Hockey Online through AO Live, produced by Petter Sports and Streaming. welcome back as we get ready for the third period here between the Novas and the Bearcats, tied up at a goal apiece. Novas trying to avoid dropping their third straight while the Bearcats looking to win three in a row. And for the Bearcats, if they can get the victory, they would clinch themselves a spot in the semifinals tomorrow evening. In fact, with their 2-0 record right now, they've almost got a spot. But a win or a tie would certainly give them enough points to say that they will play in the semifinals. But they're still looking to try and pick up the number one overall seed, as a win would give them a tie with the New Scotland Storm. And then we'd have to go into the tiebreaker scenarios, since the Bearcats and the Storm will not play each other in the round robin. If they both end up going 4-0, then we'd have to look at the goal ratios for each team. It's not just a straight plus minus. It's goals for and goals against in a ratio against one another to see who would get the number one seed and who would get the number two seed. And last year I tried to do some of those calculations on my own, but I misread the way the calculations worked, because it was a three-team tie, if I remember correctly, and the ratio only applied to the games involving the tied teams, because they had all played each other and they all went 1-1 against each other, if I remember right. And I ended up having the semifinal matchups not end up how they actually were in my own calculations, and then I ended up saying that on air and had a bunch of people send me corrections. So I'm not even going to try to do any calculations until everything is done and until we hear it for sure from someone at the league level to say, yes, these are what the semifinal matchups are going to be. I can tell you that a team that goes 4-0 will definitely be playing in a semifinal. And if two teams go 4-0, they will be the 1 and 2 seeds. But which one is which will depend on the tiebreakers. And again, we'll let the league people and the Hockey Nova Scotia people do all that math. As Doiron gets his stick up under the chin of McNeil, and Doiron's going to go off for at least two, and I would say possibly four here. No, it is just 2 minutes for head contact. And you could almost consider that for Doiron getting away with one, to only take 2 minutes for the way he got that stick up and in on McNeil. So the second power play of the game for the Novas. They are 1-for-1 on the power play so far this evening. So the penalty coming at 1:07 to Doiron for head contact. As the Novas back in their own zone. Now they work their way out. Thomas McKechnie with the puck. He'll bring it across the line, send it down towards the corner. Sullivan will get there for the Bearcats first. Plays it off the wall, and it takes one of those weird bounces, as pucks are prone to do, off of the boards and the glass here in the Community Credit Union Arena. Anderson gets the puck in across the line, but Sullivan will send it right back out again. Coming out of the net to play it is Bell, as Wolf was on his way there. Now the Novas bring the puck in, but it's offside, as in just a little bit ahead of the play there was AJ Boyd. So we'll get the stoppage with 57 seconds left to go in the penalty. 17:50 left to go here in the third period. And it's worth mentioning again, we mentioned it during the Truro versus Gulls game, but it didn't end up coming to fruition, that if a game ends regulation tied, we do not have overtime. That game between Truro and the Gulls was the closest we came to a tie game. It did end up being a two-goal margin at the end, and we've had some one-goal games. But that game was the one that was tied closest to the zeros on the clock. It was still tied with 40 seconds or 40.9 seconds left or something like that when the Bearcats scored the game-winning goal. There's a shot, save, rebound, they score! A.J. Boyd picks up the rebound off the pad of Matt O'Hara, and the Nova power play strikes for the second time in this game. And the Novas jump out in front. It's now 2-1. For A.J. Boyd, that is his second goal and third point of the tournament. His second point in this game after he assisted on the goal by Duncan Anderson that made it 1-0 at the time. They announced the goal as Cooper McNeil. It was not Cooper McNeil who scored that goal. It was clearly A.J. Boyd who took that shot. That's a couple of goals that they've announced incorrectly here this evening, and I'm not blaming the guy down in the booth. He's just reading the numbers that he was told to read by the referee, but the referees have gotten two goals wrong now. They gave credit to Ethan Frazier for the goal that was actually scored by Malky Murphy, and they've just given credit to Cooper McNeil for the goal that was quite clearly scored by A.J. Boyd. I'm going to keep it as Boyd on my sheet here, and I bet you we will see that changed before the end of the night and before it becomes official on the website as a final result. And if anybody needs video evidence of the fact that it was Boyd's goal, give credit to our awesome cameraman Duncan here. I'm sure he got a good shot of it, that it was number 10 who took that shot. 16:28 left to go here in the third period. We unfortunately don't have the, 17 different camera angles like you'd have at an NHL game, but we got a cameraman who's almost as good, so close, yeah. If you could operate 17 cameras at once, I mean, you'd be set, right? As they battle along the far side wall, Carson McEachern able to get it into the Bearcat zone. Patrickin going back after it, but McEachern takes it away from him. It comes around to the near side corner. Kieran McDonald trying to send it back down behind the net, but it comes up the wall. Boyd ends up taking a bump there from Paris, and Frazier ends up with the puck. He'll work his way down into the Nova's end. Frazier sends it towards the net. That's directed away by Bell. Now Vora with a shot, and Bell another deflection. He ends up putting that one right into the midsection of the referee. Fortunately, he looks to be okay. Puck comes up the wall to Sullivan. Waits, then sends it down into the corner. Goes behind the net all the way around to the far side. Vora gets to it there. Takes a bump from Thomas McEachern. Boyd able to play it behind the net to Anderson. Anderson will get it ahead and out to center with Watt. Watt will then dump it down into the Truro zone. Comes off the end boards, and Griffin McEachern gets it for the Bearcats. Long lead pass intended for Wolf, broken up by McLean, excuse me. And then the puck comes in onto O'Hara, and he'll cover up and hang on for a faceoff. 15:11 left to go here in the third period. We still have one more game left to go today. That's right, if you've been watching hockey with us for the last 11 hours, we're not done.
We got one more whole game to go yet.
It will be the Halifax Halifax Wolverines. Halifax McDonald's play at the U18 level, and they're in the midst of a series right now with the week's majors that I've been paying a fair bit of attention to for obvious reasons. McEachern ends up coughing up the puck there to Hookshorst, but he's able to take Hookshorst into the end boards and get the puck back for the Bearcats. Comes to the line, Van Zupten with the shot. That goes up into the end glass. No, the game that's coming up at 8 o'clock is the Halifax Wolverines, and their 1-1 record going up against the Bedford Bandits, as the Bandits try to avoid going 0-4 for the weekend. Here's Fleet with the puck now. He has it knocked away from him. Mullen will work his way forward. Mullen gets through a couple of players, gets a shot off, and Bell had to get that leg stretched out quite a bit to make the save on the shot by Mullen. Puck gets to the line, held in at the point there by Hunt. He gets a shot away and another save made by Bell. And that'll be cleared down the ice. And no icing as Hunt goes back to get it. Takes a bump from McClellan. Hunt works it beyond Broussard. Gets to the line, held in by McLean. Now it's back on the stick of Hunt. He'll get it out to center. Ahead for Hoyt. That puck a little too high for him to handle. Now McClellan with it. Will get avoid the check of White, then plays it just past Hunt. Down the ice it goes. Broussard will pick up there. He'll take it behind the net. Come out in front. Turn. Shoot. Save made by O'Hara. And Hunt clears it away from the front of the net. Hunt gets it out to center. Anderson there to knock that down. He'll play it to Carson McEachern. Across for Thomas McEachern, who quickly gets it ahead to Boyd. And Boyd deflects it down into the Bearcat zone. Cleared back out again. And back to get it is Thomas McEachern with just under 7 minutes gone here in the third period. McEachern tries to get it ahead for McEachern, but it's broken up by Vora. Now Vora with the puck, trying to get it to the front of the net for Frazier. The pass was deflected away, and then a second chance for Doiron to try and get it to Frazier, but that also knocked away. Now McEachern coming the other way. Carson McEachern with the shot. Save made by O'Hara. And Vora will get the puck and work his way back up ice for the Bearcats. Vora tried to make a pass into the middle of the ice, but it was intercepted by Carson McEachern. McEachern working his way in against Patrickin, takes it down into the corner. Patrickin stays right there with him. Now the puck tied up along the wall. Green able to play it off the boards and out to center as Trenum backs up to get it. He'll play it across to the far side, brought in by McNeil. He'll fire a shot. That goes high, comes around the boards, up the wall. Cream gets it to the line, not out as Watt. No, Watt didn't hold it onside. And so we'll get a stoppage with 12:05 left to go here in the third period. Nova's leading it 2-1 as they are hoping to hold on and get their first victory of the weekend. At last year's tournament, every team got at least one win. It worked out that nobody ended up going through the weekend 0-4. And that's where we ended up with a few tiebreakers to have to deal with. Here's Watt with the puck. He'll try and get it back to the line. It does get back to McLean. But McLean couldn't quite hold it onside, so now Griffin McEachern has it with some time. He'll start to skate it ahead. Takes it all the way to the blue line, fires a shot. Blocker save made by Bell. And now the Novas pick up. They'll come the other way. Van Zupten gains the red line and then dumps it deep into the Toro zone. Griffin McEachern plays it off the corner. Comes back to McEachern. Now he'll play it over to Wolf. And Wolf has some empty space in front of him, so he'll skate the puck ahead all the way down the right wing side, then gets taken off of the puck by McNeil. Now Mullen, and we're going to get a penalty. And they're going to call slashing on McClellan. I didn't think the Novas touched the puck, though. That's why I was confused. Yeah. So Nevertheless, it will be a power play for the Truro Bearcats. Their second man advantage of the night, coming with 11:04 left to go in the third period, as Merrick McClellan goes off for the slash. So the Bearcats, who were 0-for-1 with the power play, get their second man advantage, looking to tie up the game. There's a chance for Wolf, and that doesn't miss by much. Vora now will play it to Frazier. Frazier back down to Vora. Vora skates it up the wall. Now goes across to the far side for McEachern. Wolf picks up, plays it back to Mullen. His shot steered away by Bell, and the Novas able to clear the puck down the length of the ice. O'Hara out of his net to settle it there for Mullen. 1:25 to go in the power play. Here comes Mullen. All the way up through center into the Nova zone. Fires a shot. Bell the save. Vora gets onto the puck. He plays it into the near corner. Now back to the line for Mullen. He'll skate it along the blue line. Fire a shot. Glove save made once again by Jack Bell. And he will hang on for a faceoff with 1:09 left to go in the penalty. 10:13 remaining here in the third period. Going to get a timeout here taken by the Bearcats. They want to talk things over. So the Bearcats looking to see if they can set something up for their power play unit here, as they draw something up. We look over the shoulder of the coach, but we can't quite see the whiteboard. You just move to the side just a little bit there, coach. Unfortunately, he's not going to cooperate with us. So we couldn't quite see what he was drawing up on the whiteboard, but we'll see if the Bearcats are able to execute whatever it was that was drawn up there. Vora to take the draw, and that's going to be the first key part. Novas end up winning the faceoff, though. Vora goes after the puck in the corner, working against McNeil. McNeil loses it to Vora. Now McEachern will get it, and Thomas McEachern able to launch it down the length of the ice. 53 seconds left to go in the power play. Here's Mullen skating past Fleet. Brings the puck all the way in. Mullen comes in, gets a shot away, and he rings it off the post. Great opportunity there for Elliot Mullen. And if the puck was about 2 inches to the inside, we'd be talking about a tie game right now. Now Wolf comes in. He fires a shot. That goes high and wide into the end glass. And the puck ends up hitting one of the Nova players on the bench. The faceoff will come back into the Nova zone with 21 seconds left in the penalty, 9:25 remaining here in the third period. Hoyt to take the faceoff against Carson McEachern. McEachern wins the draw into the corner for McNeil. McNeil not able to ring it around the boards. McEachern, Thomas McEachern does, but he only gets it as far as Sheehan. He plays it to Hoyt. Hoyt now back to Sheehan. Walks it along the line. Gets a shot away. Deflection from Murphy, but it ends up going just wide of the net. And now the puck is seven ironed down the ice. Actually, that was more of a pitching wedge than a seven iron. A little flatter swing than you'd get on a 7-iron. Murphy gets it over to Hoyt. Hoyt feeds it up to Hunt, and Hunt will send it into the Nova zone. Comes around to the near side corner. Murphy picks up there. Can't get away from Fleet, though, and Fleet will play it to the line. Sheehan holds it in. We're back to 5-on-5. McLean now with the puck. So the Bearcats drop to 0-for-2 with the power play tonight. 0-for-4 overall on the weekend. White now comes away from the wall with the puck. It's poked off his stick by Carson McEachern, who is able to get it out to center. It's dumped right back in again. Now Anderson will pick up deep in his own zone. Gets away from Doiron. Gets past Vora as he plays the puck off the wall and out. Patrickson knocks it down at his own line. Tries to get it ahead. That's knocked down by McLean. Now Frazier will bring it in across the blue line. Frazier trying to get through. Lost control of the puck. Doiron sends it into the corner. Frazier and Doiron both go in there for the Bearcats, but the Novas are able to work it out, and Bora has to come out to center ice with the puck. 7:55 to go, third period. Patrickin takes a bump from McClellan as he plays the puck in. McNeil will go back and get it for the Novas. Now Doiron gets it to Frazier, but Frazier has his pocket picked by Broussard, and Broussard will work his way ahead, trying to get a step through the defense, but Paris and Patrickin able to close that door. Now Watt picks up the loose puck. He takes a hit from Doiron as they go into the corner. Hookshorst comes in as well. Hookshorst will get possession of the puck, trying to get away from Patrickin. Patrickin takes him into the end boards. Now the puck is worked to Watt. Watt ends up misplaying it, and that will allow Doiron to come out. Doiron through center, in across the blue line. Sends the puck in deep. Novas pick it up, but it takes a weird bounce off the Zamboni door, heads towards the front of the net, and Watt ends up getting the bouncing puck. Gives it to Hunter McDonald. He fires a shot, and O'Hara will glove it down and hang on to it. 6:52 left to go here in period number three. And again, don't forget to stick around after the game. We'll have the presentation of the players of the game. The players of the game sponsored by the game sponsor, which for this game is Physio One Health Clinic. We also want to once again acknowledge our tournament sponsors, and we'll do that at the next stoppage and play as McNeil plays it down into the corner. Here's Green with the puck now. His pass gets beyond Wolf. Wolf, though, able to pick it up, and McNeil recovers in a big way. Nice play there by McNeil to recover that puck. Now it's sent down across the Nova's blue line. Van Zupman gets it ahead to Kieran McDonald, who sends it down. O'Hara sets it up behind his own net for Griffin McEachern, ahead to Wolf. Wolf trying to work his way around Thomas McEachern. McEachern keeps him to the outside. They both go down into the end boards. Coming in to help out Mullen, his pass is intercepted. And it'll be Boyd working his way out. Boyd fires it off the end boards. Sullivan gets the puck, brings it around the wall, held in at the line by Anderson. He sends it back down low. Sullivan couldn't get it past his man. Now it's picked up by Carson McEachern. He'll play it back to the line for Anderson. His shot ends up coming in, and O'Hara will glove it down and make the save with 5:45 left to go here in the third period. And we'll once again remind you about our tournament sponsors, the gold level sponsor, Coltech Windows and Entrance Systems, silver level sponsors, there's three of them, Andy's Tire Shop Limited, SBM Offshore, and Maritime Trust Limited. Bronze level sponsors, four of those, Motor Hub Automotive Group, Stanfield Limited, Dairy Queen, and Birchall McDougall. Broussard down below the goal line. Puck ends up bouncing away from him. Comes to McClellan. He'll play it back to the line for McNeil. He fires a shot. The blocker save made by O'Hara. Puck gets back to the line again. McNeil gloves it down there. He'll work it down the wall and then gets a shot away. Fleet tried to get a deflection, but O'Hara able to stay with it and make the save. Now it's played out to center. Just over 5 minutes left to go here, third period. Dumped back in onto O'Hara. He'll settle it there for his defenseman Sheehan. Sheehan plays it ahead to Munden. Coming up through center. Munden takes it to the left wing side, now stops at the wall, plays it back to White, or to Hunt, stepping in, he scores! Troy Hunt with the shot. Getting a piece of it was Jack Bell, but not enough as the puck just rolls through, and the Truro Bearcats tie the game. For Troy Hunt, that is his first goal and first point of the tournament. As Munden with the only assist on that goal. So Troy Hunt from Chance Munden. Or Chase Munden, excuse me. I had that down wrong on my sheet. My apologies. Chase Munden with the assist. Time of the goal, 15 minutes, 4 seconds. And so now we're all tied up. Here comes Murphy coming in. Murphy with a shot. Kick save. Rebound. And Bora had a chance at it, but couldn't get as clean of a shot as he might have liked. Now Frazier with the puck. But we're going to get a hand pass against the Bearcats. Hunt trying to argue his case that he touched it with his own stick before Bora got it, but not going to win that argument. And so the faceoff will come to just outside the Nova blue line. 4:32 left to go here in the third period. Bearcats earlier today played a game that they led 4-0. The Gulls came back and tied it at 4, and then the Bearcats scored the game-winning goal with 41 seconds left. This time, the Novas scored first. The Bearcats tied it up. The Novas scored to make it 2-1. Bearcats have tied it up again, and we're tied in the late stages of the third period, just like the Bearcats were this morning against the Gulls. Do we have as dramatic a finish as we saw in this morning's game? Well, we got 4 minutes left to find out as Frazier brings the puck in across the blue line. Sends it down into the corner. Trenum will go in there and get it. Frazier gives him a bump. And the Novas are able to pick up and work the puck out as McDonald gets the pass ahead for Watt. Watt will send it deep into the Bearcat zone. Paris back to get it. And he'll start to work his way ahead with the puck, just over 3.5 left to go. That pass intercepted by Boyd. Paris able to come back, though, and play the puck over to the wall. Boyd gets it again, plays it down to the corner for Carson McEachern. His pass ends up hitting the skate of the referee, and that works in the Bearcats' favor as they were able to play it out to center ice, but it's sent right back in again by Thomas McEachern. Patrickin will go and get it in the corner. Puck comes up the wall to Van Zupten. His shot is blocked by Wolf. Wolf will get it ahead to Mullen. Mullen's got Doiron with him. Mullen in across the blue line. Skates through a couple of players. Gets it over to the far side for Wolf, who's able to put that one right into the net. And the Bearcats claim their first lead of this game. It's now 3-2. And what a time to get your first lead of the night as you score with 3:01 left to go in the third period. Ethan Wolf will get the goal, and for Wolf, that's his second goal, sixth point of the weekend. Mullen will get, I believe it should be the only assist, I think. Hayden Doiron also does get an assist. Yeah, that's right. I'm sorry, my brain left me for a moment. So now the Novas, who had not trailed all through this game, now are in danger of dropping to 0-3, as there's only 2.5 minutes left to go. Wolf takes a hit as he takes the puck to the line. Now a pass for Doiron in front. Doiron with a shot, and that's a big save by Bell to keep his team within one. Jack Bell with maybe his most important save of the weekend, his 29th save on 32 shots so far tonight. Jack Bell has done just about everything you could ask of him and then some. As you look at that, at the two goals scored recently, and you'd be hard-pressed to find many goaltenders at any level who would have been able to stop either of those. Here's Bora with the puck now, working in the corner. Frazier comes in to help out. Frazier takes a bump from Hookshorst. Kieran McDonald also in there battling for the Novas. Now Frazier able to get free from some of the crowd. Takes it back into the crowd to try and kill a little more time as we pass 2 minutes left to go. Bora now tying up the puck. Hookshorst trying to get it free. Now Bora will work it out, but it ends up on the stick of Kieran McDonald. His pass intercepted by Frazier. Frazier sends it back off the end boards again. Malky Murphy getting to it at the far wall, but he can't, or the near wall, but he couldn't get it under control. Now out comes Watt. Watt comes in, gets a shot away, and that ends up going wide of the net. Puck comes all the way around out to McNeil. He'll play it to Trenum. 84 seconds left to go. Trenum gets it ahead. That goes off a skate, and the rest of the way down the ice, Sullivan will go back and pick up. 76 seconds left. Sullivan now, lead pass, deflected the rest of the way down by Mullen. Trenum will go back and get it. White coming in on the forecheck. He's able to steal and create the turnover. Gets it to Mullen. Mullen with a shot and a glove save made once again by Jack Bell. That's his 30th save of the night with 61 seconds remaining on the clock. And the Novas will take their timeout now. With 61 seconds on the clock, the Novas will talk it over and try to get something set up here to get the puck down the ice, get Jack Bell out of the net for an extra attacker, and get a puck past Matt O'Hara to tie the game and get at least a point out of this one. Jack Bell with a 30-save performance this evening. He has been dynamite, as you see his goaltending tandem partner, Jake Poirier, excuse me. You got a Jack and a Jake as your two goaltenders. Jake Poirier giving Jack Bell a pat on the head, telling him how good a job he's been doing, and he really has been. 30 saves by any goaltender in any game is a good performance. Puck sent behind the net, Trenum will get it. Now he will start to work it out, gets it up to Anderson. Anderson plays the puck off the boards, out to center. Wolf creates the turnover though. Now Wolf working against Trenum in the corner. Wolf will come away from the corner, gets it across for Mullen, and what a save there by Bell. Now the puck picked up by Boyd. He'll play it off the glass, out to center. White gets to it there. He'll get it back down into the Nova zone, under 30 seconds left to go. Trenum goes back and picks up. Plays it around to the far side for Boyd. Boyd gives to McNeil. McNeil will work his way ahead. Loses the puck right at the center ice red line as Mullen gave him a check. Now Trenum up to Boyd. Boyd works it ahead to Anderson in across the blue line. McEachern plays it back out again. Van Zupten will get it across. And that will run the Novas out of time. The Bearcats go to 3-0. The Novas drop to 0-3. Truro outshoot the Novas in that third period, 17-11. Final shots end up 34-25 for the Bearcats. A 31 save performance by Jack Bell. As we'll stick around for the presentation of the players of the game. Obviously, Ethan Wolf needs some consideration for scoring the game-winning goal with 3:01 left. Matt O'Hara with a 23-save performance for Truro. For the Novas, Jack Bell with his 31 saves. A.J. Boyd with a two-point night. Kieran McDonald with a two-point night. So a few different players you can consider there. Ethan Wolf does indeed get the player of the game. As mentioned, he scored the game-winning goal with 3:01 remaining. That has secured a spot in the semifinals. And Jack Bell with his 31 save performance. He might be feeling a little dejected right now, but when he looks back on this 31 save performance, he has a lot to be proud of. And right now getting consoled, as he did everything you could ask him to do to keep his team in it. But the Novas will fall to 0-3. The Bearcats will improve to 3-0 and move back into a tie for first place with the New Scotland Storm. Bearcats and Storm both have one game left tomorrow. They'll both try to go to 4-0 on the round robin. Novas have a game left tomorrow. They'll try to avoid an 0-4 weekend. That's going to do it for this one. We'll be back with you in about half an hour. Until then, on behalf of my awesome cameraman, Duncan, this is Michael Petter saying, may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. Final score one last time. Truro Bearcats with a dramatic 3-2 victory over the Novas. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy the rest of your Friday night.